Today's show is pre-recorded.
Y'all know what time it is. Y'all don't know y'all better act on that. Hat on, hat on, suit on, suit on, looking like the dapper dawn. Giving a microphone, dress, dress like a million bucks, bucks, things in its cuffs. Mm-hmm. Y'all tell me who could it be but Steve Harvey. Oh, yeah. Listening to me. Put your hands
I sure will. Good morning, everybody. You are listening to The Voice. Come on, dig me now. One and only, Steve Harvey got a radio show. I say it every day because God been good to me. God has done some things in my life that's been truly been just amazing. And really amazing ain't even really the word. They don't really have a word for what he's done for me. I'm just out of superlatives. That's why I say it every day. Steve Harvey got a radio show because God is in the blessing business. Yeah, he is. God can help you turn your life around. Did you hear me? God can help you turn your life around. Whatever you're going through, God has an answer for it. See, but it's the going through that gets us, though, ain't it? Because I was having a moment yesterday, and I sat my wife down. I said, baby, I just need to talk to you. I'm going through a little bit right now. I just wanted to share, which I'm a little down right now. And my wife reminded me. She just reminded me. This is what a good mate does. A good mate reminds you just of things that sometimes you forget when you get off track. Because, you know, I consider myself a motivational type person. I try to listen to people and then give them something I've learned along the way on this journey I've been on. I try to give a person a takeaway. But even being that person, sometimes I get off track myself. I get a little low sometimes. You know, I get a little down. Sometimes I forget some of the stuff I say. It ain't that I forget it. I guess I just get caught up in the grind of doing it. And sometimes I get a little off course and I forget some of the things. And my wife or a mate can be good for you to remind you. And she just says, Steve, God got us. She said, have you ever noticed that every time you get in a spot? And she say, and I know how you must feel because you out here working. And you keep turning around and old stuff keep popping up and you get a call from your accountant and hear this done went wrong and that done went, you steady trying to fix it. But you steady going, wow, man, what is this? She say, but you ever notice he always, no matter what, provide a way. And he ain't ever too late. Oh, you might be going, the deadline is approaching. The deadline can come and pass, but then they have a grace period for you. And then sometimes, man, it's just you go down there after the grace period and they take the payment anyway and you're good anyway. But see, ain't that God bringing you through it? It may not be when you want it, but he right on time. Just before you get put out, just before they turn. Maybe they cut the lights off, but you get it back on just before company come. or just before the weekend get here. See, he always comes through for you. And she had to remind me of that. What you're going through is necessary. Look, circumstance and hardships and pitfalls are always untimely. If you keep the law of attraction in play, if you keep believing that that he gonna see you through this, just like he do when you don't believe it. That's what the cold part is, though, ain't it? Ain't God brought you through even when you didn't really have the faith to say he was gonna bring you through? But because of grace and mercy, he brought you through anyway. But because you forgot to thank him, or you didn't pay attention through the come through, you just was telling people, oh man, if you'd have seen me, it was so jacked up. Man, I was so turned up. I ain't know what I was going to do. I almost got put out. I was going to see, keyword, almost. You forgot that part right there. And then it looked like I won, man. And it seemed like every month I go through this same thing. And then, then somebody ought to just say, did you pay it? Yeah, I paid it. Did you get put out? No, I'm cool. See, you need somebody on your shoulder to say that to you. And then you need somebody to come right behind him and go, man, ain't God good? Really, man, that's how this works. See, you keep getting in situations, but he keep getting you out. Now, if you jump, listen to me. Hold on. Let's say you in a frying pan in the skillet and the oil is up and you in there frying and you uncomfortable being fried. God somehow, or let's just say you managed to get out of the hot grease in the frying pan and you standing there next to the skillet. Looking at the fire, continue to heat the grease. You get out, and then for some unexplainable reason, you dives right on back in there. Ain't that how we usually do it? I'm just asking you. God gets you away from the man you've been asking to get away from. Then you go right back over there and start seeing him again. It's amazing how many times God get us out the fire, and we walks right back in there. Ain't it amazing, man? And I mean, really, man. See, this how I break life down for me. So I don't get over here stuck on stupid with myself and then get to doing something ignorant like blaming God. When really, man, God has given us as human beings the power of decision. And we all make decisions. How many times, man? See, sometimes it's a blessing in getting locked up. You can ask a lot of cats I know, man, to tell you. It was a blessing for me, man, because I was just headed the wrong way steady. But he locked me up, set me down, made me miss my family, miss being out here being a free man, made me realize that my family was important, made me, man, really see this girl for what she was. When I get out, man, I'm on the straight and narrow. Well, then when you get out, though, see, you can't be talking about, no, oh, man, I can't find no job. Now I'm going to go and do what I got to do. No, partner. You got to do now what you're supposed to do. See, that don't do what you got to do got you in trouble in the first place. See, everybody, see, the hood got a lot of ignorant rules we done created. I got to do what I got to do. I got to feed my family. Well, only reason you got to do what you got to do is because you didn't do what you were supposed to do. See, if you just went on to school like your mama kept telling you. Oh, man, I was watching 48 Hours yesterday, and a dude named Nesto was on there. And Nesto, Latino dude, said, man, my mother told me quit hanging with these guys. They were going nothing but trouble. I should have listened to her. He doing 30 years right now. You can't blame God. That's why I talk to myself this way, so I don't get stupid and start shifting the blame the wrong way when it's really on me. How many times has God got you out of something and you walk right back into it? Man, why don't you take these blessings God give you and go on about your business? That'd be the best way to do it, don't you think? That's what I think. So I thank God for my wife for reminding me that God got us anyway, that God gonna pull you through anyway, that have you noticed, Steve, we ain't lost a beat. Oh, I know it's hard out here, but really you ain't lost a beat. You still moving forward. You still dressing nice. You still look good when you come into that job. Everybody don't got to know you, that your house is in bad shape and all that. God got you, man. If you just hold your head up, man, quit complaining all the time about what you ain't got. And as in the words of my daddy, Slick Harvey, stop talking about what you ain't got and take a good look at what you do got. That's improper grammar, but that always stuck with me, and maybe it'll stick with you. Quit talking about and looking at what you ain't got. Take a good look at what you do got.
You're listening to the Steve Harvey Morning Show.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, inpatient, outpatients, whoever you are, this is the Steve Harvey Morning Show. All of you, today is about entertainment.
Yes.
If you are coming to us for more news about the corona, all our news is the same news as yesterday.
Hello.
All we got for you new is Kevin Durant got it.
Yeah.
Moving on.
Yes, it does. Yeah,
that's
true.
And we're praying for everybody with it. Speedy recovery. God bless us all. And everybody else, be careful. Wash your damn hands. If you don't know that by now, I don't know what else to tell you. That's our corona advice for the day. She's back, ladies and gentlemen. Best voice in all the radio, Shirley Strawberry.
Hi, guys. Hey, Steve.
Welcome
I am back.
Shirley.
Oh, Shirley.
Hi.
First of all, your mic is a little hot, and it sounds like
I'm a little congested, but I don't have it now.
Have you been tested?
No, let the people who really need to be tested be tested.
I need everybody to take a picture of Shirley Mike. Don't point it this way.
Shirley, you straight?
But, Steve, I'm not really mad that you're asking me that because the same way. Yeah, I would be the same way, so go have at it. I understand, because you know how I am. I don't even want to be in the same room with someone.
Well, let me ask you
this.
Is you feverish?
No, I'm not feverish. None of that. I don't have any of those symptoms. I'm not tired.
Symptoms out.
I'm not tired. I don't have... Huh?
Okay, let me ask you this, Shirley.
Yeah, I have...
Can you hold your breath for 15 seconds comfortably without coughing?
Yes, I can. And that's a myth, Steve. That's not true.
I don't give a damn if it is a myth. You ain't took the other test.
So at least take this one.
This is my test. Carla Pharrell.
Yes, good morning. Welcome back, Shirley girl. You good, my sister? You good?
I'm good. Thank you. Thank you, Carla, for holding down the strawberry letter for me, girl.
Is you really good?
Okay.
Am I
no problem.
Here?
Elbow bump.
Yes. And ladies and gentlemen,
I know,
the 6,745th wonder of the world, Junior Wonder Boy Spate.
Morning, everybody. Uncle, I got a pen and paper. Every time you cough, I write it down.
Not the
you
cough tally.
My laughter will lead into King a fools, cough, so don't make Tommy. Me laugh.
Yay, yay, in the building, baby. No coughs, no nothing. I'm good, man. I'm good. I am good. But it's a new day. Let's get it cracked.
I know. You can't have a cough these
Hump
days.
Day.
Did you sneeze?
I did not sneeze.
Okay, all right.
And I'm not going to say nothing to y'all, but we have a new segment today that is going
what?
To be very enlightening. We have
a new segment?
Segment today. Created especially for somebody. Y'all, ladies and gentlemen, stay tuned. Your first time this morning hearing from the legendary Mississippi Monica.
You kidding me?
On the
you
damn
are kidding
radio.
Me?
When we come
what?
Back, we got questions for the CLO right after this.
You're listening to the Steve Harvey Morning Show.
All right, time now. As Steve mentioned earlier, it is time now for Ask the CLO, the Chief Love Officer. And Steve, this one is from Halima out of New Orleans. It says, my husband and I have a question about a situation with our daughter-in-law and son. We cannot understand why our daughter-in-law chose not to take her husband's last name, our family name, when they got married last year. What reason could a woman possibly have not to take her husband's last name? We are Christians, and this is deeply troubling for us. What do you think about this? Interesting.
Well, two things.
Ooh.
What do Christianity have to do with it? The next thing, you said she's your daughter-in-law, meaning they're already married. Too damn late for this letter. And then the next point of business is, I don't know why a woman would not want to take her husband's name. I don't have a clue. It could be because times are different. It could be because, you know, women's lib. It could be the movement. I don't know. Let's ask a woman. Shirley, why wouldn't a woman take a man's last name?
Well, for a number of those reasons you've mentioned, because she wants to remain and retain her own identity. You know, there's no rule that says you have to take the man's last name. So she chose to just, you know, be on her own. And obviously her husband was cool with it because he still married her. They had fellas, to know that, you know.
Here's a question for the fellas. Tommy, is that a deal breaker, yes or no?
It's close, huh? It's close.
What about
it's
you?
Real good. Serious about those names.
No, it ain't no deal breaker.
Lose the woman over a name? Over a name, yeah.
Hell no. Yeah. Call yourself what you want.
See, we got three opinions.
But my wife would be one.
Tommy said.
But Steve, you did ask this one.
That's real close right there, man.
Junior said, no, it ain't a deal breaker. Tommy said it's close. And for me, it's a deal breaker. It would just be a deal breaker.
And Junior ain't got nobody. Junior ain't got nobody.
And I'm married. And I took my husband's last name.
Yeah, and if he does, if Junior does get someone, he says he doesn't care.
It's not a deal breaker to me. No,
is it an age thing? Is it?
And that's cool. So. I mean, I'm old school. I'll admit it. So that's all to it. So.
And the other thing, Steve, is what about if she? It didn't say this, but hyphenate. She can hyphenate her name. Keep her
well,
last
what
name.
About this
you know
right
what?
Here,
that's
though.
A whole nother story, though, Shirley.
Yeah.
Are men cool with hyphenation? You know what I mean? I don't know if I'm cool with hyphenation. I think if I marry somebody, I want you to take my name. That's just, maybe I'm just old school, you know? But
yeah, I think that's what it is. And you have to discuss that. You know, you will already know that before you marry this woman, whether or not she's going to take your name.
Right. I mean,
and
ain't no
it's
problem.
It's not him that's writing, it's her parents.
Well, for the parents, though, and then here's one last point of contention. We go to the next question. Okay. It really ain't your business.
Yeah.
No, okay.
Let the church say amen.
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 Amen again.
Amen.
And I just did that because they was Christians. Go ahead.
Mr. CLO. Sean in Columbus, Georgia says, I'm 45 years old and me and my girlfriend were together for 16 years. I cheated on her in the beginning. I knew it was wrong and I apologized. We moved on. Fast forward to 3 weeks ago. She goes to her friend's wedding back in her hometown. And she was acting different at the wedding, after the wedding. I caught her texting an old friend of hers. Excuse me, hold on.
Did she just
I had
call?
A cough, sorry.
That's two.
Well, hold on.
Three.
Hey, Shirley, you got about three more coughs. Yeah. One more cough. Shirley, you got about one more cough.
No, your ass
your
is
out of
here. Yeah, you're getting quarantined.
I told you I was going to cough.
I'm just trying to tell you right now, Shirley. You got one more cough in here.
Cough if you want to.
Okay,
we don't need you to do the rest
of
the show.
Oh, my goodness.
Well, Tommy, you did it.
How you think I did that? All I did was ask her what she...
No, that's not all you did. You said you got one more time to cough. That's what you said.
I said
that.
And did he not say that, guys? Did he not say that?
And then she called.
And that was the line.
And then you said, you got to get your ass out of here.
Okay, so let me ask you this then.
Huh?
Okay, so let me ask you. How many of y'all cool with the cough?
Not with this job.
How many of y'all
cool with the cough survey?
I'm just asking. Who cool with the cough?
Yeah.
She been out for 2 days. She come back in here coughing.
Yeah.
Who cool with...
Well, if you're ill, you got to stay home. So she's gone.
Got to get on up.
She left, though?
Okay, she left. Now,
yeah, she's gone, man.
You see her leaving out the studio?
Okay, but listen to me.
She's not coming back in here.
Take her mic and set it on fire.
See, this kind of stuff right here. This right here.
I mean, if she gone, let's get all the corona and everything out. Let's set the mic.
I'm with Dog on this one. Now.
On fire.
Set the mic
I ain't normally with Dog, but I'm with Dog on this one.
Set her chair on fire.
Okay. Come on, give
let's
that
get
alcohol.
A small fire started in the studio. And do anybody have fire extinguisher spray? Because I heard that kills it, too.
Yeah.
So she really sick, though? Is she really sick?
Tommy. Took her wipes with her. Took her wipe. Damn us. Took her wipes with her.
You ran her out of here.
Oh, don't put it. You know what? For you to put it on me. She coughed.
You had a part in it, too,
She
Harvey.
Coughed, huh? did she or did she not cough?
Cough her ass off. About five times. Big hawking ass cough, too. Like it was something deep.
Coming
cough
up
all
next.
About the lungs.
I love it.
Are you finished?
I love it. I love it.
Are you finished?
I love it.
Are you quiet?
That was lung coughing. I'm sorry. Go ahead.
Now, on the real, though, she ain't really just lead, is she?
Tommy,
yeah, she
gone.
She's not in the hallway. She gone.
Coming up next, nephew Tommy.
Run that prank back. Come on. Right after this.
Yeah. You're listening to the Steve Harvey Morning Show.
Coming up at the top of the hour in national news, Joe Biden. He had a big night last night. Well, Miss Ann will break all that down. Plus, in entertainment news, Kevin Durant has tested positive for the coronavirus.
That's
crazy. We'll talk about all that. Yeah. But right now, it's on you, nephew. What you got? Run that prank back.
Is that your husband? Now, I ain't going to ask you too many. I'm going to ask you one more again. Is that your husband? Let's go, cat dog.
Hello.
Hello, I'm trying to reach Karen.
This is Karen.
Karen, hey, listen, my name is Mark. Are you married to Jason?
Yes.
Okay. All right. I got the right person. Listen, I don't even know how to say this to you. My name is Mark. I follow my wife today.
Uh-huh.
And I'm at a park, and I'm almost certain that my wife is right now, I'm about 200 or 300 yards away, but I'm almost certain my wife is holding hands with your husband, Jason. So
okay, hold on. When you see my husband at the park with your wife, how long have you been following them?
I followed my wife this morning because I just was feeling like real weird about, you know, something going on. And I followed her, and I'm at the park right now. And, you know, I think she's with Jason. I think she's with your husband.
What type of car do you see Jason in?
A Lexus.
What color is it?
White.
Okay, that's him. So he's supposed to have went to work today. And this Sunday, and they had some overtime that he's supposed to be doing at work today, and he's at a park with your wife. Are you close to them?
I'm not close to him. I tried to stay back. Wait, hold up. She just kissed him.
She just kissed who?
My wife just kissed your husband.
What'd you say your wife's name is again?
My wife's name is Veronica.
Veronica. Okay, what park they at?
They at Langley Park. I'm at Langley Park right now. I'm about 200 yards away from them, and I'm looking at, she just kissed him again. I cannot believe this, man.
I know well. You're not telling me that your wife is kissing my f***ing husband. How did you get my number? That's all up. Back this up. How did you get my number, and who are you?
Like I say, my name is Mark. A buddy of mine named Fitzgerald. Fitz knows. He knows Jason.
I don't know Fitzgerald. I don't want to know how you get my number.
Fitz gave me your... Fitz told me he knew Jason and some kind of way got me your phone number. I don't even know who he got your number from. All I know is your husband is kissing my wife right now. That's what I know.
Okay, you just sitting there watching. Give me the number. We can change this right now. You sitting there watching on some Spectre Gadget. I'll go and bust all this up because I don't play that. Because he said he had to work this morning, some little overtime. Don't have time. Then who does that in the park with somebody? It's too cold to be in the park anyway. You can't feed no ducks. Give me the address of this Langley Park.
Okay, wait a minute. They getting a blanket out the car.
Now, who does that? I know well, he ain't no romantic type of guy. He never take me to no park, but
they getting a blanket out the car and going deeper into the park. I cannot believe this. They getting the blanket. Now, I'm looking at...
Give me the park address.
They got wine and wine glasses.
Mark, give me the address of the park. You on some white boy stalk. I'm trying to go. I'll bust that up. I don't have time for that calling me all startled and watching your wife. I'm not going to watch and I'm going to hand him his ass. Okay, let's stop this right now. Take your over there to the park and give him the phone. I don't have time for this. You sitting up there watching your wife with my... You calling me. What kind of you? You okay?
Say what?
You supposed to be up there getting on that. Because if I was there, I'd be the slap that. And I've been handing him his cap. Go hand him the phone. Take up there and hand him the phone. What the hell are you calling me for?
I'm trying to see what else they gonna do. That's what
you
I'm trying to do.
Thing. You done seen enough. All that pouring that be over there doing, pulling out a guy. What you want? Wait to see him? Take your ass over to hand him the phone. I know Jason ain't in no park with no. I'm got my at home. I am on our third child pregnant with a baby. But I don't give a. I'll go up there and whoop his while I'm pregnant. I know well Jason ain't in no park with no. Don't hand him the phone. You
I want to see. Let me step out the truck. Hold on. They drinking wine right now.
I don't give a about that. Go hand him the phone. Walk over and hand him the phone. I don't know what you do with yours. I don't play about mine.
Oh, man, they kissing.
Mark. I don't know who you are, but go hand him the phone. Go hand him the phone. You sitting up there watching with your weak. Who in the are you anyway?
That's my wife he with. He with my wife.
You must be old. Because if you was one of them big old yoked up black one of them got on his. Who does that? You sitting up there watching him at the park. I'm telling you now, I'm whooping that when I see her. I'm whooping your wife. Then I'm whooping Jason. And I'm going to slap your calling me with this. You sitting up there calling me, got my blood pressure sky high while you sitting up there watching my husband with your wife. You supposed to be all on top of that. Okay. Yeah, when I see you got that coming too. But I'm going to find this Langley Park right now. I'm going to get off the phone because I'll be up there. I'm going to show you how.
Okay, hold on. Somebody want to talk to you.
Give him the phone. Right.
Hello,
who is this?
This Tommy.
Tommy who?
This nephew Tommy from the Steve Harvey Morning Show. Your husband Jason got me to prank phone call you.
This is some you almost made me have my baby up in this house this morning. And I got two more months to go.
Your husband Jason got me to prank phone call you.
He know better than that shit. I'm whooping anyway when he come home.
He told me, he said, look, man, my wife is a no-nonsense. She don't take no drama, none of that. He
that
told
don't
me.
Make no sense, because I was like, what man sit there and watch their wife at the park? What man does that? This is crazy. But you tell him, I got him. Mm-hmm.
Hey, I got to ask you this, baby. One more thing. What is the baddest radio show in the land?
The Steve Harvey Morning Show. Yeah. I'm going to get Jason with this. No, Tommy, I'm going to get you. I'll tell you what I'm going to do. Yeah, I'm just going to name the baby Tommy. Tell him that for a joke.
Tell him you're going to name the baby Tommy?
Yeah, tell Jason that I'm going to name the baby Tommy.
I really think I'm the greatest that ever has done this.
Well,
yeah.
I'm
well,
the greatest.
You ain't only the greatest pranker. You sure know how to hurt people's feelings, too.
And run but that's what I do, Unc. That what
I know.
And you
don't
want to. I'm gonna tell you this, Unc. They trying to come out now with a prank, a movie. It ain't me. When you decide to do me, then you gonna have a prank. Mm-hmm. You can do all these prank movies you want to do, but if it ain't me.
Uh-huh.
You ain't winning, partner.
No,
so whoever doing this new prank, Tiffany Hash in it, it ain't me. If you gonna do a prank movie, it's got to be me. And I mean that. I'm not tripping on anybody that's in the movie. But if you gonna do it, you gonna have to come get the greatest that has ever done it. That is.
All right, thank you, nephew. Got it.
And I mean that, Carl.
All right, baby. Coming up at the top of the hour, entertainment and national news.
You're listening to the Steve Harvey Morning Show.
In today's entertainment news, Brooklyn Nets star Kevin Durant has tested positive for the coronavirus.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's big right there, man.
No,
that's,
not KD. Not KD, right. The team announced four players have tested positive for COVID-19. Durant says he's feeling fine, but he did add that everyone needs to be careful, take care of yourself and quarantine. We're going to get through this.
Yeah, so, we're going to get through it, y'all.
I hope he's all right. He's gone through a lot already, though. You know, we know that. Just what? On what he's gone through as an athlete, you know, I just hope he's all right.
With the Achilles and all?
Yeah, with the Achilles.
With his injuries?
He done went with his injuries. Well, he's gone through a lot.
I mean, you know, to truth be told, all of us going through a lot on some level about something. You know, yeah, it's just that right. When you hear the famous get it, you know, people pay extra close attention. But it's a lot of people getting this, man. It's some people dying. This ain't nothing to play with. Just everybody need to be careful. Quarantine yourself for a little while till they get these stations out here started where you can get yourself tested. You know, and they can start curbing this thing. That's all got to happen.
Yeah.
And then we need somebody that's had it for a few weeks to recover and go, oh, man, I made it. So we can stop calling it a death sentence.
Yeah. And that's not what it is.
Yeah, there's a lot of people that have recovered from it. A lot of people.
What else you got, Carla?
In other entertainment news, listen to this, Steve. Joel Osteen and Kanye West, you know, they had to pull the plug on their big plan to throw that massive service that they were going to have at Yankee Stadium, at least for the time being. The Yankees, you know, they're canceling all of their events for the next 2 months, and that put Osteen and Kanye's service right in the middle of that. So it's also safe to say that Kanye's Sunday service is on hold, too. So, you know, the coronavirus, it is just changing the way we live in every aspect.
Well, yeah, you know, can't go to church. You can't go to Kanye thing. That's all.
That's it, yeah. Crowds you know? Of people.
Nah. That's just how it is.
Yeah.
That's just how it is.
It ain't the first Sunday you done missed. It ain't the first Sunday you done missed now. Let's quit playing.
Bedside Baptist.
you done missed a lot of service.
Come on now. This ain't the one that's going to send you to hell.
Yeah. So it's a lot going on right now.
It's real though, Paul. Everything is real right now.
It really
now.
Is.
Is everybody taking the right safety measures that we're supposed to take?
Mm-hmm.
That's what we're supposed to be doing. But I mean, I'm worried. I'm worried that can I possibly have something and don't know I have it? Because when I think about, like you said, Idris Elba, you said that yesterday. Idris Elba got it.
Yeah, Idris Elba.
But hey, I'm just as sexy.
Facts. Wait, hold on. Let me amen Junior on that. Facts, my brother.
I'm just as sexy.
You got that right, Junior.
Junior, I'm just as sexy as Idris. And I mean that.
I know they what you
thinking. What you have to say, baby? You are correct, Junior. What you
okay.
got to say?
Well, let me say it then, because Junior won't let me say it. I'm just saying, I don't want to say nothing now.
Idris what?
Hey, man. You ain't got to be. Even if you ugly, you can.
Stop saying your name. In the same sentence as Idris. Cause you're
trying to go
throwing
to the top
everybody
of the
off.
Chain. All right, listen.
I look all right. I look all right.
All right, let's go. Let's pull it together, Steve. You got to introduce Miss Ann. She has a lot to get to. Let's go. Come on.
What are you laughing for, Junior? What is that? What did you
Miss Ann laughing too? Because I know.
Miss Ann Tripp.
I would, but I got to start it with such bad news. But yes, Tommy, really? Okay. This is Ann Tripp with the news. All right, let me start out with the latest national coronavirus stats. I know you want to know those. They keep changing, but right now there are 5,838 confirmed cases in the United States, 107 people have died. And now all 50 states reporting at least one confirmed case of COVID-19. West Virginia was the last state to check in. In the NBA, yes, you just heard, now Kevin Durant and three other Nets players have tested positive for the virus. President Trump urging Americans to stay home as much as possible to prevent the spread of the virus. And now Treasury Secretary Steve Mnuchin says the administration is ready to hand out money to those adversely affected by the steps taken to tamp down the COVID-19's infection rate.
We're looking at sending checks to Americans immediately. And what we've heard from hardworking Americans, many companies have now shut down, whether it's bars or restaurants. Americans need cash now, and the president wants to get cash now. And I mean now, in the next 2 weeks.
According to a recent poll, about 1 in 5 American households have experienced a layoff or reduced work hours because of all this. Trump's now asking the Congress for an additional $1 trillion stimulus package to prop up the economy. That would be the largest economic rescue package since the recession of 2008, when the Republicans complained about Obama wanting some money need to help people out. A pair of brothers in Tennessee being threatened with prosecution because of their price-gouging gambit over bottles of hand sanitizer. According to the Times, Matt and Noah Colvin admit they took a 13-mile road trip across Tennessee and Kentucky, buying over 17,000 bottles of hand sanitizer and selling them for $70 a pop each bottle. Anyway, they found out about them. Now they say they'll donate the rest to a church and to first responders. Three primaries yesterday. Joe Biden won all three over Bernie Sanders. He beat Sanders in Florida by 61%, 59% in Illinois. He also won Arizona. And finally, Roll Britannia. Well, looks like Queen Elizabeth is making for the exits behind Harry and Meghan, but not for the same reason. Since the Queen is 93 years old and her husband, Prince Philip, is 98, her advisors thought that it would be a good idea to get her out of Buckingham Palace and to into Windsor Castle. Windsor Castle from Buckingham Palace is about 25 miles away, just to have her in a healthy, safety environment, again, because she is 93 years old. There are more than 1,400 confirmed cases of coronavirus in the UK, with at least 21 deaths reported. Now back to the Steve Harvey Morning Show.
You're listening to the Steve Harvey Morning Show.
Yesterday, Tom Brady announced he is leaving the New England Patriots. Tom,
and hold up,
Patriots.
Hold up. Right up there, yes, with that news, Tommy said that he, Idris Elba, he was concerned.
You damn right. You damn right.
He might have something because Idris got it. You don't get your name out
of
this damn sentence.
I don't want to hit it. Carla, what are you saying about Tom Brady?
Tom Brady.
Yeah, please.
Stop, Steve. So Tom Brady, he thanked the Patriots, the staff, the coaches, Coach Bill Belichick, the Kraft family, and all the Patriots fans for his legacy, six Super Bowl championships, and the memories. But check this out.
Yeah, he out.
Tom Brady is a Tampa Bay Buccaneer.
Wow.
What?
Yes.
Wow.
Yes, sir.
What?
Yes, so where is $30 million per year?
How much?
$30 million per year.
Wow.
Tom
Now, Tommy,
Brady.
Are you finna say where's Jameson Winston?
I don't know where he went, Uncle Steve.
Where he
I don't,
went?
Honestly. Honestly,
he,
I don't know where
he went. He in his house evidently. Under the bed.
Knowing he lost his job.
No, yeah, where is he now, though, Carl? Do you know where Winston is?
No, I don't know yet.
He's still
I don't
roster.
Know. Yeah, so he might be the backup, Junior. Junior would know.
He could be the backup.
He's still there.
Yeah.
Oh,
but,
my
you
God.
Know, man. He going to figure out he's going to have to make a move. Maybe he might ask to be released.
Oh.
I'm try to find him another job.
So what do you think, God. Steve? Tom Brady, a Tampa Bay Buccaneer.
Well, they still ain't going nowhere.
You don't think?
Hey, don't you think he should have retired though? On the real though, for real, don't you think he should have retired?
For what? He want to play? Let him play. He healthy?
Yeah, but you still 40. Pro? You 40 what? 41, 42?
How old is you, Tommy?
I know how old I am, but you don't have to tell the whole world. And I'm not finna be playing. I'm not playing no football.
Come on.
Still thinking you're sexy.
I'm not finna play.
Thinking you as fine as Idris.
No damn me, football.
How old is you?
No, I'm just asking. But answer the question.
I'm not answering the damn question. I'm not answering it. I'm not going to do that.
Okay, let me tell you how old you are. You're 52.
I'm not playing no football is what I'm saying. And I don't think Brady need to be playing none either. He's done everything you can do.
Well, he's with Tampa Bay, so get ready.
Hold on, Carl. You kiss my ass, Uncle Steve.
I'm going to call him for real.
All right. Put up 34 after the hour. Trending news, black people and the coronavirus conspiracy theories. We're going to talk about it right after this.
Yay, yay.
You're listening to the Steve Harvey Morning Show.
We've all heard conspiracy theories about black people and we can't catch the coronavirus. And most recently, singer Carrie Hilson, she posted a crazy theory about the radiation of 5G technology caused the coronavirus. But later, she took that post down. Actor Idris Elba, you know, we talked about Idris yesterday. He Steve, this is serious. This is a serious moment. He tested positive, as we know, you know, for the coronavirus. And he did an update on how he's doing since he announced that he tested positive. So, and he addressed this issue, this whole conspiracy theory about black people. Take a listen.
Please stop sending the conspiracy theory nonsense about black people not being able to get coronavirus or COVID-19. It's dumb. It's silly. It's very dangerous. There are so many weird conspiracy theory things going about. Please, guys, now's not the time, all right? If you're sending that stuff out or manifesting it, it is not the time. People need to know facts, need to understand the truth so that they can protect themselves. Stop sending this stuff out. It's very dangerous for all, not just black people, but everyone, because the more we can understand the facts, the better we can deal with it.
Okay. All right.
So true.
Sense.
Yeah,
that's all right, Idris.
And you know, Tommy, I know you wanted to, you know, compare yourself to him earlier, but you know, he said that black people can get it, and you can. That's ridiculous, huh?
I ain't saying nothing negative about that.
Oh no, 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 you didn't. No, oh no, not at all. No, you didn't say nothing negative. And but I want to be clear to you too, so there's no
listen. You know, let's get something clear between me and you. I'm just as cute as Idris. And I'm not going to.
What?
Man, you cannot be serious.
I don't even look at.
Why are y'all laughing?
I don't even look at men, but I can clearly tell you, if we go around and take a vote, you ain't going to get one. You ain't going to get one. You ain't going to get one.
I ain't finna do this with y'all. I ain't finna do this with
Tommy.
You don't have to. You don't have to.
Carla Jr. Steve. Yes. I'm just as cute as Idris. And I know man.
Jesus.
I am.
Jesus.
Okay, Precious.
Wait
Jesus.
A minute, this information don't is call out me no Precious. I work with now, you.
Because it was condescending.
I go around the country, Tommy, and every time somebody asks me about you, it's never how fine your ass is.
Never. I ain't heard anybody say it. Yeah, and I got news for you. You ain't either.
So I ain't as cute as Idris.
Have you? Let me ask you a question. Of all the roles you have had in your life, has any of them roles been the cute dude?
No, but I'm just saying.
Bam. You know why?
Because
when you ask for casting call, you know not to carry your little ugly ass down there. Now I told you to stop all this, and just so we be clear about this. Idris has made it clear. Black people can get corona, and I want to clear something else up for you, Tommy, too. Short people can get corona, too. Don't walk around here. All these myths, because you think because you're short, the germs is going over your head. You get it.
Oh, God. He's only talking to Tommy.
I'm not. Carl, I'm not finna do this. I know.
What? You're not finna do what?
So, your little short, ugly ass did not look like Idris, and quit saying it. Now, you're
I ain't nowhere near as... stop. I'm nowhere near stop as cute as Idris. Is that what y'all doing?
We know.
Hell,
we know.
You.
Hey, Tommy, let me explain, especially for the sisters out there that are listening. For us, it's Denzel, Idris. That's like top of the food chain to us.
Yeah.
Right.
Okay,
there.
So I ain't
those
nowhere
two.
Near
those
Idris.
Those two off the top.
Uncle Steve, you don't have nothing to do with this.
Let me just say this.
Carla, am I anywhere close to Idris? Mm.
Dog, it's a UPS driver here to you.
What?
Yourself.
What? I'm a earthworm?
All right, we got to go. Coming up next, Nephew Tommy with today's prank phone call.
You're listening to the Steve Harvey Morning Show.
Coming up at the top of the hour, right about 4 minutes after today's strawberry letter, the subject is my boyfriend's ex-girlfriend has moved in. Has she now?
That's a lot to follow.
Boyfriend's ex-girlfriend.
has moved in. That's it. That's okay. The letter. But right now, nephew, what you got? You got a prank phone call for us?
Musty's son. That's what I got. Musty. Musty's son. Y'all got some kids that's musty? Don't sit up and act like you ain't had it. Let's go, cat dog. Musty's son.
I don't have none.
Oh, so your grandkids ain't musty?
No, not a one of them. No.
Now, one of them?
No. Is your kid stank?
Hell no.
See how that sound?
All right, here we go. Musty's son. Let's go, cat.
Hello,
I'm trying to reach Vanessa, please.
This is she.
Hi, Vanessa. My name is Robert. I'm the one of the owners. You know my wife, Michelle. We own the daycare.
Yes. How can I help you?
Okay. I think we've had your son, Malik, probably close to a year now. Am I right?
Yes, you have. Is everything okay?
No, everything is fine. Everything is fine. I don't think we have a problem that we can't clear up. I have a question for you. Have you been noticing anything different about Malik, like concerning hygiene at all?
Hygiene? No, not that I can recall. What are you talking about?
Okay, how old is Malik?
He's two.
Okay. Well, we seem to have come across a little glitch here that we're going to try to take care of here at the daycare. I told her I would make the phone call and leave her out of it. I know you see her every day once
you drop.
Yeah,
but what glitch are you talking about? What is this glitch?
I'm sorry?
Glitch. What is this glitch that you want to talk about? I'm confused.
Okay. Well, actually, what we're having is it seems like every day here lately for the last 2 months, Malik has been, you know, very musty. You know, he hasn't been really sweaty, but just real musty.
Okay, you clearly have the wrong child, because I give my son a bath every night, and most mornings before he leaves the school, I give him another bath again. So, yeah, I'm pretty positive you have the wrong child.
No, ma'am. Your son is Malik, right? And he's 2 years old. You guys have been here with us right close to a year now, correct?
Yes, and?
Okay, and he's a cute little kid with the curly hair. I know exactly which one he is. So what I'm saying to you is that we are having problems. He's just reeking, you know. He's real musty.
Okay, so, you know what? My son does not reek. I don't know what child you're talking about, but you're not talking about my child. I just told you I make sure that he gets a bath every night. So that's not my child. My child is very clean.
Okay, well hang on, Vanessa. What I'm trying to get you to understand is this is why my wife didn't want to call, okay? And I'm glad I'm actually the one that made the call. What we need to do, this is what I'm going to do. I'm just going to try a little experiment for the next month or so.
Experiment?
I'm sorry?
What do you mean experiment? What kind of experiment?
Well, what I'm going to do is I'm going to put some male deodorant on him.
What?
For the next month, and we'll see how it plays out.
No. You're not going to put anything on my child. That's not going to happen.
Okay, well, ma'am, I'm trying to fix the problem here. I just wanted to call.
He doesn't have a problem. I already told you that my son is clean. You're not going to put any deodorant on him, and if you do, it's going to be a problem. Do you understand me?
Okay, ma'am, I'm not trying to have an argument with you. What I want you to know is,
well, you're talking about putting deodorant on my child. You crazy? You can't do that. I'm not going to have that happening. Please don't make me have to come back to that school for you and your wife.
Okay, ma'am, listen, we're going to have to do something about your child. Your child is musty, okay? And you're sitting here getting an attitude with me, and I'm trying to let you know your child
is
musty.
You're talking nonsense. Maybe you're the one that's musty. Maybe you and your wife are musty. My child is not musty. I keep telling you that I bathe him every night. Which part of that don't you understand?
I understand everything that you're saying. Maybe it's the soap. Maybe something is not taking effect. I'm not sure, okay?
But maybe he doesn't smell it right, because I don't know what child you're smelling, but you're not smelling my child.
On him.
You are not using male deodorant on my child. Do I need to come down there for you with the cops and sue your entire establishment? You don't want that to happen. Stay away from my child. Are you crazy? You know, matter of fact, where's my son?
Ma'am, your son is fine. Your son is in there with the rest of the kids. They're playing. Today is the first day I sprayed a little bit of male deodorant on
his arm. You did what? Let's
see how that worked out.
Okay, so you clear. Look, Cheryl, can you cover for me for a couple of minutes? I'm bringing my there right now. I'll be there within the hour, because you must be crazy. What do you mean you sprayed my son?
Ma'am, I just sprayed a little bit of deodorant on him just to see if we can.
I didn't give you permission to do that, and I keep telling you that there's nothing wrong with my child, and you took it upon yourself to go and spray my child, and you weren't supposed to do that. Are you crazy? I'm bringing my right now.
Okay, well, what are you coming here for? The boy is, your son Malik is fine. Why are you coming here?
No, he's clearly not fine. If you're going around spraying, why don't you spray your, because clearly your smelling and reeking and funky as hell. I didn't give you no and spray my child. Damn, I'm going to come down there, and I promise you, I promise you, I'm going to shoot all y'all, because you crazy.
Okay, let me say this, ma'am. Your son is musty. He's been reeking for the
my
last
My son
time.
Is not musty. How many times have I tried to tell you that he's not musty?
Okay?
You know what? I ain't even trying to hear you, because you clearly crazy. How you go around spraying people's kids? And I with my child. Did you smell the other kids? You know what? I'm about to get in my car and come down there for your ass, because you must be crazy.
Hello? Hello?
Hello?
Why did you hang up on me? I'm trying to fix the problem, ma'am.
Wait, what the f- you want? I told you that I'm coming down there. I'll be there in 10 minutes.
But I needed to let you know one more thing that's going on here.
What could you possibly need to let me know? Because I'm on my way to right now.
Where are you now? Are you in your car? Where are you?
I am heading to my car, about to get in my car to come down there for because you must be crazy spraying my child.
Before you get to your car, I need to tell you one more thing about your son, okay?
Please, what you possibly have to tell me?
I want to tell you that
what?
This is, listen to me, this is nephew Tommy from the Steve Harvey Morning Show. Your girlfriend Cheryl got me to prank phone call you.
What the f***? That you know, I'm standing here in the parking lot about to come down there for and that knew exactly what I was about. I'm going to get her. I'm going to get her because I'm thinking, I know my child is musty. I know my child is clean and he don't smell. Ooh, I'm going to get her.
I just talked to her. She said she's right here in her cubicle. You got to call her right now. I said, okay, just chill out. I'm going to call her. We
yeah,
got
I'm going to get a you don't know.
Hey, is Malik nice and clean?
Malik is always nice and clean and smelling right. So I don't know what the hell you were talking about. I was like, not my child. He got the wrong child. You are about to get it. You don't even know.
Oh, man. All right, Vanessa, you got to tell me one more thing, baby. What's the baddest, and I mean the baddest, radio show in the land?
The one and only Steve Harvey Morning Show.
There it is. Musty son. And I, but you got, you got at least let me know I did it right, though. Did I do it right?
Hey, dog.
Oh, yeah, it was
do you, it. Do you, let me ask you something. Do you want credit every day for
hey,
every day?
Yes,
for
I do.
Yeah, validation.
I do.
He needs validation.
I want my
Steve.
Stupidity to be recognized, huh?
Oh, dog.
I did Musty Son. It was good. Mm-hmm. I want you to acknowledge it. Why can't you do that for me?
I thought it was, yeah.
What?
Yeah, you do, we tell you every day, though. Just
every
like
day,
Steve
dog.
Said, we tell
we
you
We tell
this
you all
day
long.
Day.
Yeah. It's the okay. need for it every day that throws me
But
off.
When I ask for it, why is it a problem?
It's like when you on stage and they threw applauding for you and you ask them for some more.
Mm.
Yeah, hello?
Yeah. You know,
no, that, but, not but, every now and then. It's
no,
every day.
No, it's every,
right.
day. Every day.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's every day you want some more.
And it's can coming across as needy. Mm-hmm. It comes across as
lack of confidence.
Yeah, insecure.
Can I say y'all change? Can I say y'all change?
No,
can it be y'all?
Well,
can I say y'all change?
Well, we have gotten tired of it. Yeah.
I wasn't going to say it to him, but
no,
thank
I'm
you.
Just going to go and put it out there.
Why do you not like my stupidity?
No, I don't like nobody's stupidity. Yours is a form of shame for the family, though.
Oh, wow. Oh, it got deep.
That hurt me. Now, that hurt me.
Yeah,
okay.
I tried to,
hurt.
Too. Yeah, that was intentional.
Oh, Uncle Ned.
Yeah, I tried to cut
right,
you deep down to
Let's
the white
go.
Meat.
Let's go. We got the strawberry letter coming up next.
You're listening to the Steve Harvey Morning Show.
Time now for today's strawberry letter. And if you need advice on relationship, dating, work, sex, parenting, and more, submit your strawberry letter to steveharveyfm.com. Click submit strawberry letter. Shirley is out. Steve will read the letter. I'll respond. Let's go, Mr. Hobbit.
Buckle up!
I don't need
right.
that.
You don't need all that. That's
I don't right. need all of it at all.
Hold on tight. We
My
got it for you. Here it is.
Nobody need that.
Strawberry letter.
Don't nobody need that. Yeah, and the person that needed you ran off, so.
I didn't run.
Just save it for tomorrow.
No.
When
don't
she comes back.
On me.
All right, here we go. My boyfriend's ex-girlfriend has moved in. What? Dear Steve and Shirley, I've been dating a man for almost 4 years. I'm trying to do the right thing by not living with him before we're married. I live alone, and he shares a house with a guy that he's been friends with forever. My boyfriend has one child that he has joint custody of, but he doesn't really get along with the child's mother. I've had a few run-ins with the child's mother, but recently things between us got worse when the woman moved in with my man and his roommate. The roommate is dating her.
Jesus.
And my man has no problem with that, and he agreed to let her live with them. I was so upset when I found out, so to keep me calm, my boyfriend spends most nights with me now. But this woman has made life a living hell for me so far. Whenever my boyfriend and I have plans, she will leave the house at the last minute, leaving my boyfriend with the baby. Of course, I can't get mad because it's his child. But I know the child's mom is doing this on purpose. She's also posting pictures on social media of the three of them. My man, her, and the baby. Like they one big happy family. My man told me to chill out because as long as she's there, he doesn't have to give her as much money because she's not paying rent anymore. Look, I don't want to be naive and not look at the bigger picture. You think my boyfriend may be enjoying this arrangement? I found it odd that he has no problem with his best friend dating his child's mother. Is that odd, or am I just looking for reasons to hate on this girl? Steve and Shirley, what do you think is really going on here?
All right, Steve, to this lady, you've been dating this man for about 4 years, and you all are trying to wait until you get married to live together. So what's taking so long? 4 years? That's a long time. Anyway, he lives in a house with his best friend, and he has joint custody of his child. And you and his baby mama, you guys are beefing. Now his baby mama has moved into the house with your man. At first you said guy and roommate, and then later in the letter you said his best friend. So that's a difference. That's a big difference to me. And now she's dating him. You had a problem with all of that, you know, them all living together under this one roof, but your man is cool with it, and he spends most of his nights with you. So you feel like, oh, girl, she's causing problems because she's posting pictures of you and your man and the child on social media like they're just one big happy family. But baby mama is slick, you know, because when you and your man, you guys make plans, she leaves him with the child. And your man, he says that he's cool. He's cool with her living there, and he wants you to chill out because he feels like that's less money he has to put out, you know, to take care of the kid and her. So I think he's just trying to keep the peace, spend less money, see his child. But I find it hard to believe, Steve, that he is cool with his best friend dating his baby mama, and they all live together. There's something wrong with that to me. So is he lying about them being together? I don't know. But I know you don't trust him. And if you want this man, you don't trust him, you need to talk to him and work out some issues, because you are going to be dealing, if you're going to marry this man and be with him, you're going to be dealing with her baby mama drama for a very long time, because they have a child together. So your feelings are valid, and I'm not saying they're not, but you have to come to terms and see what's going on with the three of them. What's happening with that? Steve?
Let me just get to this letter right here. My boyfriend's ex-girlfriend has moved in. You saying has moved in with his best friend, who they are now seeing each other, and the baby then moved in too. Let me say something to you. Black dudes don't do this.
Okay.
White dudes don't do this. Latino dudes don't do this. Native American dudes don't do this. Asian men don't do this. I don't know of any group of men that'll go along with this arrangement. First of all, my best friend ain't dating my ex that's got my baby.
Okay.
and he's dating her, and me and him live together. And now she done fell on hard times and done moved into that house. What? This is the most unbelievable piece of mess I've ever heard of in a long time. This is virtually impossible to do. First of all, here's what I think the deal is. And I got 30 seconds, so you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to, this is what's called a cliffhanger.
Okay.
Here's exactly what I think is going on. I'm going to tell it to you when we get back, and you can feel how you want to feel. But this right here, this stinks. This has an odor to it. And I'm going to tell you what I'm smelling right after this.
Good. 23 after the hour. Steve will break it down right after this.
You're listening to the Steve Harvey Morning Show.
Okay, Steve, come on. Let's recap today's strawberry letter. You got us hanging.
This is crazy. The name of this letter is My Boyfriend's Ex-Girlfriend Has Moved In. But that ain't the clicker. Moving in with who is what's hell. You've been with this man for 4 years, and you trying to do the right thing by not living with him before y'all married. That's what you call doing the right thing. Well, your boyfriend got a child that he got joint custody with this other girl. But now the story is he don't really get along with the child's mother, right? And you done had a couple run-ins with her, too. The roommate, who is his best friend, is now dating the girl that his best friend had a baby with. What?
What'd he do that?
What?
Right.
Goes straight left right there, don't it?
What?
Right.
The roommate is dating her, and your man ain't got no problem with the fact that he agreed to let her live with them. Wait a minute. What? Girl, what? When you was typing this letter, how did it sound to you? Because this right here stinks. Like I said earlier, black dudes don't do this. White dudes don't do this. Mm-hmm. Latino dudes don't do this. Native American dudes don't do this. Asian dudes don't do this. That about cover everybody I can think of. I don't know no dudes that do this. Now, right. I could be wrong. I've never heard of this. But here's what I think done happened. I think him and the ex that don't get along fell on some hard times. Now, in order to give her a place to stay, he done constructed and construed this whole thing with his best friend and her to go along that they are a couple now. They date. I think they've created this story that they're dating. I want you to say y'all dating so she can come and live here. You say to keep the peace, most nights he spends the night at your house to keep the peace, but some nights he don't. So when he at your house, who bed her and the baby in? And I can promise you it ain't crossed the hall with his best damn friend. So I think this smells like a dude that's trying to help his girl out, created some story that they best friends so she can live there. Now part of this is true where he ain't paying the rent. He ain't got to pay as much child support because he ain't got to pay no rent. But the rest of this stinks. This don't make no damn sense. She ain't had nowhere else to go. Where her mama? Where her daddy? Where her sister?
Right.
She over here at her ex's house. Now your man told you to chill out because long as she there, he ain't got to pay no money. Now, I don't want to be naive and not look at the bigger picture. Do you think my boyfriend may be enjoying this arrangement? Well.
Don't say it. Yeah.
She said, I find it odd that he has no problem with his best friend dating his child's mother. Is that odd? Is
exactly.
It odd? That ain't odd. That's crazy.
You said it don't even happen, Steve.
Slap smack ass crazy. This
right.
Is no, this crazy? This is unheard of.
Right.
As a male species, this is not how we function. You cross the hall banging my ex-girl. Where the baby at?
Who's the mother of your child?
Dog, where is the baby at while all this going on? This my daddy. But my daddy over there laying up with the other man. What? Who done sold this to the baby? And then when you go out, she leave early and leave the baby with him. But hold up. She posting pictures online, the three of them like they one big happy family. Mm-hmm. Where she getting the pictures of the three of them at?
At the house.
Where the four of them stay.
Uh-huh. Come on, Cole Cracker.
She getting the pictures of the three of them where the four of them stay. Where is your man, your dude that's dating her, why they ain't on social media with their pictures? Mm-hmm. You know why? Because he got another chick somewhere, and he can't explain this to no other chick, black, white, yellow, green, or brown, that he is screwing his best friend's girl that's got his baby that stay in the bedroom across the hall. What?
Right? What? Okay, oh,
girl. Girl, what? Girl, what?
Right. What? What'd he do to that?
What, where's this?
Yes.
What? What? What country? What village? What township? What, what space station? Where they do this
Don't forget
at?
Parish. What parish?
Where's this at? What dungeon? What basement they doing this? Girl, girl, are you being naive? Is he enjoying this arrangement? He got her over there. He got her over here. You over there. The baby got a place to stay. He can see his son when he want to. She go out when she want to because she got a built-in babysitter. She going along with the arrangement because she trying to squeeze it back in. She posting them pictures to throw your ass into something because she want him back. And if you keep letting this go on, she going to get him back. Hell, she got him now if they living in the same place. You did the right thing by not living there. Where her right thing at?
All right. Man. Post your comments on today's Strawberry Letter at Steve Harvey FM on the gram or on Facebook, and check out the Strawberry Letter podcast on demand. Now, coming up at 46 after the hour. It's homeschooling is going on, and we dealing with this. We're going to talk about it right after this.
My child finna flunk, though.
That's what I had.
You're listening to the Steve Harvey Morning Show.
All right, nephew, we were talking about this, Steve, Junior, all of us. We were talking about this the other day off the air. And due to the coronavirus, as we know, the outbreak, school is out. Tommy, how's it going with you? Homeschooling, lesson plans?
We're at a standstill. I can't help you if you cannot carry the one. If you are not carrying the one in your math, I can't help you. I don't know this new math, and I'm not finna learn the new math. You either gonna learn my math, or we not finna get nowhere. And I can't help you. We gonna carry this one the way I've been carrying it all my life.
But they don't do that anymore, Tommy. They don't do it anymore. They don't carry
the one anymore. But I still do it, Carla. Tommy. When I do math, I ain't got no calculator, Tommy. I carries the one.
Tommy. Hey, your baby finna fail.
Okay, hold on. You saying that you don't carry the one no more?
Dog, all I know is carry the one, but that ain't what they doing no more.
Okay, so
I don't know how to lead the one over there. Well, where the one go?
Carry, after you carry him.
Why would I make some money and not carry it with me?
Okay.
I'm taking the one. Oh, I'm taking the one, partner.
Carry the one.
Yeah.
So, what am I supposed to do? My kids are off.
Hire a tutor.
Okay. All right.
Somebody all that right. knows something. You already ain't got good sense. Why is you teaching the babies?
Wow.
But, I ain't going to lie. I ain't carry the hell out that one. I'm cold with that one when I carry it. Yeah, but I care that one. Yeah, I care.
That's not
I
the
cares.
Only man.
Hey, man, one more time. That ain't what they doing no more.
Mm-mm. So
keep carrying the one.
Let me ask Steve this.
Well, how is they getting
Steve.
Their ass? They ain't carrying the one, Carl.
Hey, all your kids, Tommy, is in the gifted classes. You ain't ever been in that.
Nah, that's real. I was never in them classes. How do I help kids while we are quarantined right now?
Steve, help us.
First of all,
help us, Steve.
You've been a parent longer than all of us
hey,
on
man,
this show.
Buy your ass a tutor. Quit tripping. It ain't what you do. Tutors don't cost that much. Your baby fitting to fail if you don't get a tutor to that house quick.
You got to get tired of hiring.
Do it online.
Little ignorant baby going to be up at the school, tutor. The only one carrying the one, looking crazy.
Tommy up there frustrated.
All I say is God bless our educators. That's all I got to say. Coming up at the top of the hour, what you got, Steve?
For the first time ever on our radio show, the mouth of the South, Mississippi Monica,
you
makes her
me.
National radio debut.
What? With,
come on, man.
This is called A Sip of News.
I
coming
like
up
it.
Right after this.
You're listening to the Steve Harvey Morning Show.
Okay, Steve, introduce her. Let's go.
Ladies and gentlemen, I can't tell you when traveling this globe, people go, you hear that cough in the background? That's her. Ladies and gentlemen, they say, Steve, who is Mississippi Monica? We done looked her up. She kind of cute, dog. Yeah, she is. Pretty teeth, hair always done. You know, nice girl right here, single. But we affectionately call her Mississippi Monica, alias the mouth of the South. And she's from Mississippi. And she's going to come to us with a brand new segment, everybody. This has never been done before. This is called A Sip of News.
Wow.
This is just a sip of news. Mississippi Monica, how you doing?
I'm all right. I just got off the phone with my aunt and them. They,
Wait a minute. Hey, good morning, Monica.
Well, good morning,
hey,
Monica.
Oh, hey, how y'all doing? Hey,
Monica.
Happy
See
Wednesday.
That right there.
Happy Wednesday.
That lets you know
happy
right
Wednesday.
There. Amy. Amy now. See, the word is aunt.
So go ahead, Steve. Yeah. Go ahead with Monica.
So,
it's Amy now.
But she said
well, they
Amy
just done left Costco. You know, Jackson got a new Costco. They done left Costco, and they down there mad at the girl because she won't let them in with their Sam's card. And I'm trying to tell them.
What?
Yeah, they called me because they trying to go back today because, you know, they going to be out there when Sam, when Costco open. But yesterday, they went and the girl won't let them in. I said, well, you not a member. They said, but it's the same thing. I said, no, it's Costco. That's Sam.
They trying to, hold
so
on,
now they
on,
mad.
Back up. They trying to get in. They trying to get into Costco with a Sam's card?
Jesus.
Yeah, because they say it's the same thing.
But it's well, not. They two different stores, Monica, they're competitors.
Well, just tell them to look at the card and read the front.
They done threatened the girl down and told them I let them in.
Okay.
Oh, no good,
are you
no
ready?
Good.
Are you ready for your segment?
I'm off the phone now. What's up? How y'all doing?
We good, Monica.
Hey,
what
Monica.
An attitude. This is...
Why you got an attitude already?
No, this is perfect. This is what we get every day. Fine. Go ahead. Let them have it.
Well, you know, I got some people that stay down there in Hattiesburg, and they done got four dogs down there. They talking about diagnosed with the corona. I don't know how they know these dogs got corona, but now they can't find the dogs. And the people that own the dogs, they mad at them talking about where the dogs are. Who let the dogs out? So, you know.
Who the let dog
the dogs
out?
Got the corona disease?
They say four dogs down there got it. And if they don't find these dogs.
This Hattiesburg.
Down there, down 49 somewhere.
Oh, I see all this news come out of Mississippi.
Yeah.
This from Mississippi, Monica. Okay, I'm with
you.
Let's go.
Oh,
yes.
See.
Oh,
yes.
Hard to keep
all this
up
going
with.
On in Mississippi.
Okay, that's Hattiesburg. Okay.
All right, y'all, we just beginning. For those of y'all just tuning in, this is Mississippi Monica with a sip of news. All of this news comes out of the great state of Mississippi. It's just called a sip of news. Go ahead, Monica, what you got next?
Carly, remember I was telling you about the little award show they had, and like the 25th year in a row, y'all, the sexiest luxury vehicle in Mississippi. Guess what it is?
What is? It's a Rolls Royce.
Dooley's pickup truck. Nuh-uh, the pickup trucks, y'all.
That's for 25 years?
25th year.
Whoa. The pickup truck is... Wait. Hold on, back up.
The sexiest vehicle in Mississippi is
a
pickup truck.
Pickup truck. Now, listen, I want to let them know, too, down there, that my aunt and them, my aunt Maggie and Bruce, Uncle Bruce, they selling plates outside the church. They going to stack them up on the card table. And they got a bucket out there. So all you got to do is drive up, put your $10 in the bucket. And they German Shepherd going to be out there to make sure that you put your money in there. And they going to be looking out the windows of the church.
How's
you laughing?
Stuff right here. This country. This
they
is
trying to make sure everybody can eat. Why are you laughing, Junior? They got the plate stacked up. They wrapped them in
foil. They looking out the window.
Oh, yeah, they don't want to be out there. So you just put your $10 in the bucket, and the dog is out there.
The German Shepherd going to make sure you put your 10 in the bucket.
Why?
How are your German Shepherd
you think? We don't want nobody stealing stuff. See, that's why I don't tell y'all nothing. I'm finna go.
Okay.
I gotta get to Target anyway. I gotta get
all
to
right,
Target.
Bye, Monica.
Oh, man. Oh, thank
I
you.
I love it.
Y'all see,
we'll be
back
in 20 minutes after the hour.
You're listening to the Steve Harvey Morning Show.
Well, Steve, big Vegas casinos are closing. MGM is closing 13 of its casinos and hotels on the Strip until May 1st. The Wynn is shutting down a couple of its own hotels for at least 2 weeks. Wait,
world coming to an end now, man. World coming to an end now. Hell, they closing Vegas. They don't close Vegas for no damn body.
I thought Vegas
wrong.
Never ever shut down.
Dog, it's something wrong.
Yeah. It's doing it now.
Yes. They say once the virus clears, we will return to normal. And you've got to think, because just like you, you love Vegas. Tons of people will travel to Vegas to blow off some steam after all this is over. Right, will you be though. One of them, Steve?
Man, hell yeah. I was going next Friday.
I threw you into something.
Man,
with
you don't even understand. You messed my whole day up.
The virus is a beast, man.
I'm hurting so bad right now.
No shows and nothing on Broadway.
I still,
no,
I still think we can bounce back.
Broadway is closed, yeah.
I think we can bounce back.
All that.
I do.
Oh, we can. Man.
Yeah.
We're America strong. The whole country, yeah. Yeah, we got this. All right, we'll be back with more trending news at 33 after the hour.
God's people, this is Kirk Franklin.
Hey, this is Chaka Khan.
What's going on? This is your boy, Kevin Hart.
Hey, what up? This your boy, Chris Brown.
What up, though? It's your boy, Big Snoop Dogg.
Hey, this is Tyler Perry.
Hi, this is Taraji P. Henson.
This is your boy, Sad the Entertainer.
Bless up, it's DJ Khaled, and you're listening to the Steve Harvey Morning Show. There's morning shows, and there's the greatest, Steve Harvey Morning Show, another one.
You're listening to the Steve Harvey Morning Show.
Yesterday, Tom Brady announced he is leaving the New England Patriots.
And hold up. Right up there with that news, Tommy said that he, Idris Elba, he was concerned.
You damn right. You damn right.
He might have something because Idris got it. You don't get your name out of the damn sentence.
I don't want to hit it. Carla, what are you saying about Tom Brady?
Tom Brady.
Yeah, please.
Stop, Steve. So Tom Brady, he thanked the Patriots, man. The staff, the coaches, Coach Bill Belichick, the Kraft family, and all the Patriots fans for his legacy, 6 Super Bowl championships, and the memories. Great. But
so
check this out.
Yeah, he out.
Tom Brady is a Tampa Bay Buccaneer.
Wow.
What?
Yes.
Yes.
Wow.
Yes, sir.
What?
Yes, so $30 million per year.
How much?
$30 million per year.
Wow.
Tom Brady.
Are you finna say where's Jameson Winston?
I don't know where he went, Uncle Steve.
Where he went?
Honestly, I don't know where he
went. He in his house Abedilli. Under the bed.
You know what? He lost his job.
No. Yeah. Where is he now, though, Carl? Do you know where Winston is?
No, yeah. He's still in the roster. Yeah, so he might be the backup, Junior. Junior would know
for
him.
He could be the backup.
He's still there?
Yeah.
Oh,
but,
my God.
You know, man. He going to figure out he going to have to make a move. He might ask to be released.
Oh.
I'm trying to find him another job.
So what do you think, Steve? Tom Brady, a Tampa Bay Buccaneer.
Well, they still ain't going nowhere.
Don't you think he should have retired though?
On the real though. For real. Don't you think he should have retired?
For what? He wanna play, let him play. He healthy.
Yeah, Unc, but you still 40 thumb? You 40 what? 41, 42?
How old is you, Tommy?
I know how old I am, but you don't have to tell the whole world. And I'm not finna be playing. I'm not playing no football.
Come on.
Still thinking you sexy.
I'm not finna play
thinking you as fine as Idris.
No damn football.
How old is you?
No, I'm just asking. But answer the question.
I'm not answering the damn question. I'm not going to do that.
Okay, let me tell you how old you are. You're 52.
I'm not playing no football, is what I'm saying. And I don't think Brady need to be playing none either. He's done everything you can do.
Yeah. Well, he's with Tampa Bay, so get ready.
Hold on, Carl. You'll kiss my ass, Uncle Steve.
I'm a comic for real.
All right. Coming up, it is the last break of the day.
It's the last break of the day.
Steve's closing remarks at 49 after the hour.
You're listening to the Steve Harvey Morning Show.
All right, guys. It's the last break of the day. A lot of stuff going on.
There's a lot going on, man.
Yeah. Social distancing. Yeah, schools are still closed. We're still in it.
I just like my phone to ring, Carla, because everybody know you at home right now. Everybody know you home, so everybody call.
What you been doing, Junior? What you been doing? After you get off work, after you get off the air with us, what do you do?
Try not to answer the phone. Just go home, don't answer the phone. Because if the phone call you get and it start with, what you doing? Hang up. Right away. The next statement. Yeah. Everybody doing the same thing.
That's what I'm doing. I'm keeping my distance.
Just hang the phone up. Because you finna get some side effect coronavirus news. Like, Douglas just got out of jail. He ain't got nowhere to be quarantined. What,
did
it ain't gonna be
him? Did you just say Douglas?
Douglas just got out of jail. He ain't got nowhere to be quarantined. What, it ain't gonna be him?
It ain't that many more Douglases in the world, dog.
So, this quarantine side effects.
Yeah. Hey, man, let me do this closing remark because I want to give people a little something. Because it's,
come on, Steve.
One of the, things I was thinking about, you know, as a person of faith, I want to share with you a big mistake that I've made as a person of faith. I guess there's some people that can relate to this. I don't know, but I'm just being honest about it. And maybe you can relate, and it might help you the way it's helped me once I came to the understanding. One of the big mistakes I've made as a person of faith is that sometimes when I pray, as soon as I'm done, I want the answer. I'm talking about as soon as I get through praying, I want the answer. I want the solution to the problem. I'm talking about immediately, right now. See, because sometimes I forget that who I'm praying to actually hears me. And he has the answer, and he has the solution, and he's already got it worked out, and he's worked it out in a way that I may not understand or see how he's doing it. And he does it oftentimes in a different time frame than what I expect or even want to accept. Man, I don't want to repeat that. I just hope you understood what I just said. Now, me wanting my prayers answered immediately is unrealistic. And you know why? Sometimes I have to trip because I have to catch myself. Because if I'm honest, the things that I'm usually praying about, it ain't just pop up today. Oh, now you have circumstances that pop up. I'm not saying you don't. But I'm saying the stuff that I usually am praying about on the average, it ain't just pop up today. I didn't just get in trouble today. I've been creating this situation, whatever situation I'm in, for a while. This woman just didn't decide to leave you today. No. We was doing something to cause her to want to leave for a while. Ain't no woman just popped up and left today. No. We do stuff. They didn't fire you just today. Trust me. This firing has been in the works, y'all. They done had some meetings, some evaluations. So when we pray, what I had to learn was we can't use God like he the magician on tonight's show. We got to wait on the fix. We got to wait on the answer. See, the answer and the fix is coming. The prayer will definitely get answered because this is what I had to learn. When you ask God for something, he ships the package immediately. But now, here's where faith comes into play, y'all. After he ships the package, he never tells us the date that the package will arrive. You have to remain faithful. I cannot tell you how many times we have asked God for something. He shipped the package to us. We lost the faith waiting and waiting. And because it didn't come when we wanted to, we stopped believing. We lost faith. So the package that can only be received by faith, that package has to have a place to be received. The package that God sends to you has to be signed for, or it has to be returned to sender, because wasn't nobody home. Nobody was there to receive it. Nobody was available to sign for it. Because the person that requested the package in the first place has moved off of Faith Street. And so the package no longer had an address to be received. The moral of what I just told you is, when you ask God for something, you have to keep the faith and wait for it. Because the package is on the way. It may not come when you want it, but it's on the way. But if you lose the faith that is coming, if you stop believing and move off of Faith Street, there's nowhere for the package to be delivered. There's nobody home, nobody to sign for. The package got to be returned to sender. That's it. That's all that's been happening. And I can't even tell you how many times that has happened to me over the years until I figured it out. Those are my closing remarks. I hope that helps you too. Y'all have a great week. In the morning. Yeah, y'all have a good week. Bye. See you, little Idris.
For all Steve Harvey contests, no purchase necessary, void where prohibited. Participants must be legal U.S. residents at least 18 years old unless otherwise stated. For complete contest rules, visit SteveHarveyFM.com.
You're listening to the Steve Harvey Morning Show.